Scala is a programming language. It's now 12, 13 years old.
This is Martin Odorski, a full professor of the IC School at EPFL and founder of the Scala programming language.
It's a general purpose language. You can do all sorts of things with Scala. It's used for many different applications in science, in open source, in industry. It runs on the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine, but there are now also versions on JavaScript, and there's a third one, which is more a prototype version for Scala Native on LLVM.
Scala was invented in 2001, and since then, the number of users has kept increasing. Its adoption rate has been one of the most remarkable ones among programming languages, although so far it is less popular than the truly big guns like Java, Python, or PHP. But why was Scala started in the first place?
The original motivation was that we wanted to show that a combination of functional programming and object-oriented programming could be practical and powerful. I've been researching sort of on the intersection of imperative, object-oriented, and functional for a while with like calculi and Popper papers and things like that. And Then at some point we did a language called Funnel, which was like a more research language, a minimal language, sort of out of a calculus, which was called join calculus at the time. And Funnel showed that, yeah, in principle, that's interesting and nice, but there were lots of things lacking, so it wasn't really a very practical language. So then the next iteration was to say, well, let's pick something that's practical, and that then became Scala.
So the truly big ideas of Scala is really the merging of two different ways to write code. Basically, you can either list functions for a computer to run and tell it in which order it should execute them, or you can organize your code around the definition of objects and the way these objects interact with one another. Of course, any function-based code can be translated into an object-oriented code and vice versa. But some codes are easier to write in one way, while other codes are easier to write in the other way. Scala's original motivation and main selling point is the ability to do both in a single programming language. And we'll dig more into this issue in a future video. For now, it's worth mentioning that Scala has other selling points.
It has a solid runtime. It runs on the JVM, which is a very widely used and solid platform. It has seamless interoperability with Java, so Java is a very popular language, so that's another selling point for it.
Another interesting feature of Scala is that a lot of thought has been put to allow for concurrent and parallel computing.
I think the other selling point is really that you can start with essentially Java-like programming and progress to the more functional thing, and the language supports you all the way for doing that. It's not like a big jump where you have to learn something completely new and after 6 months maybe you resurface and are a born-again programmer or something like that. In Scala, it doesn't work that way.
Now, inventing a new programming language is very much like inventing a language. You need to define a vocabulary and a grammar to know how the terms of the vocabulary can be combined. But to make the programming language popular, Martin Odorski and his collaborators also had to develop tools so that computers and humans can more easily interpret and interact with the programming language. These tools are called compilers and IDEs.
So the compiler is the tool that analyzes your language. So it will take your program and it will in the end produce machine code that the computer can then execute. And on the way, it will analyze your program to check whether there are any errors in it.
And this is very important because when you're coding, you are going to make errors. A good compiler pinpoints error and hints at possible fixes.
That's what a compiler does. And an IDE, that's a short name for Integrated Development Environment. So that's essentially the editor which lets you essentially do the editing of your program. It helps you finding all definitions or completion of, so you can do space, control space, and then it will sort of insert the next method for you. These sort of helpers. And to work it, actually, an IDE needs a compiler sort of inside it to understand the program that you're editing.
Now, said like this, it almost sounds easy and basic, but developing a compiler and an IDE actually represents a huge amount of work.
Both of these are fairly sophisticated tools. So the compiler is roughly 100,000 lines of code, something like that, and an IDE is much bigger than that.
A language that doesn't change the way you think about programming is not worth learning. And trust me, after learning Scala, it will change the way you program.
Functional programming and object-oriented programming up to then haven't really been combined much. There were some attempts, but they were not really successful. And Scala is sort of the first mainstream language that does that.